the strength to gather together in this time to remember a good old story and to ponder its meaning and significance for us even now. It has been a busy night at the church. Earlier we had the earlier service, and at the same time there was the Out of the Cold program happening in the back part of the church. We were pleased to welcome our guests. We were concerned that even on this night there was 350 people coming in for a warm meal and a sense of community. So we celebrate this night, the good news of God and Jesus Christ. We celebrate the fact that we have the opportunity to be together in the community, but we also pray for a world where such programs are no longer needed. This is, however, a time of celebration, and it is a time of community and a time of communion. And as well as welcoming you to this worship service, we want all of you to know that you are welcome later in the service to participate in the sacrament of communion in this place. You do not need to be a member of this church. You do not need to be a member of any church at all. This table has been prepared for us at the cost of Christ's life, and as he who calls us together to know his love and to remember what he's accomplished for us. So come to the table and enjoy, and remember how much you are in need. Let us continue in our worship during this time. Let us stand together. And sing the wonder to serve you as we
help us to ponder your words of love by the light of your Spirit, that we may proclaim glad tidings of peace and welcome Christ in our world. Amen.
The first lesson is being read from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. This passage may be found on page 706 of the Old Testament in your few Bibles. A reading from Isaiah. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy and harvest, as people exult when divided plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the barrels rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son is given. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice, with righteousness, from this time onward, forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. This passage may be found in